Hey everybody, how we doing? It is about 1:30 in the morning on what's today? Would be Thursday morning. Thursday, yeah, because the 4th was yesterday, or day before yesterday, whatever. Anyway, I'm out here this time of night, or the morning, because the hotter it gets, the slower I get, and the hotter it gets, the less I can be out here in the shop. It's just, heat index is well over 100. We got pretty lucky in June. June's usually a hot month for us, but all the rain that we had kept it down a little bit. But it's been dry for the last week or so, and I just can't take it. So I went in, went to bed early, got up, and come out here, and I'll try to do my finishing work and all that night like this. So I cannot take the heat. And I can turn the air conditioner on out here, but its power bill goes like that, and you know, just one thing after another. So I got a whole bunch of finished up stuff I want to show y'all. It's all but finished. I got to make sure everything's final sharpened, and I'm going to package everything up in the morning and try to get to the post office tomorrow. Now, first thing, Kevin, my brother Kevin. Okay, you're all fixed up. And I'm going to do it in the morning. Tomorrow I'm going to resharpen that for you. I cleaned it up a little bit. Don't let that blade rust. Alright, see, well, I'll show you next. I got an exotic. This is a hybrid striper skin. Some of those we caught up in Ohio. Now this is, I'm telling you, it is not easy to work with. I ruined one trying to take the scales off after it had been in the freezer and all that. So the scales are still on here, but they are sealed up. I don't think they'll go anywhere. Looks pretty good. And this is a regular dude fillet knife. It is for Mr. Joshua. If you can see that. And that will be on the way to you shortly. I do have some more of these skins, but I've got to change the design on the sheath to use them. And we're going to try something else. My buddy J0 is going to, when he catches some more, he's going to try to scale them first and then dry them. And we'll try them again. See if they're easy to work with like that. Next exotic, we have a gar skin. How about that? Now this is a Ohio gar. Came from, J0 caught this one. This one is actually going to my buddy over in Louisiana. It is a Creek Skinner. Now he got first dibs on the gar skin because he wanted one before when I had those other ones and I ran out of skin. So he got the first one. I do have enough skin to make one more scabbard like this. And then I have another gar skin coming from the East Coast, Florida gar skin. Got another one coming in the mail, so I'll have enough to do two or three anyway. All right, so that'll come out to you. Let's see, Miss Dixie. Now there are two of these. They are bamboo choppers. Call a bamboo chopper. use them to split bamboo with, or weeds, or like a mini machete type thing. Now they're sharp, very sharp, and they're actually made to chop, not to cut, but to chop. That's why that edge is, the edge geometry is made for chopping. So there's one. Put you a pink lanyard on there. Leather scabbards. And here's the other one. Same thing. Now these are 1095 high carbon steel. Very sharp. And after you use these, you might need to wipe them down and put a little bit of oil on, some kind of oil. That'll keep them from rusting. Keep them in good shape. Let's see what we got next. Andrew, my buddy Andrew, he sent me this one. You wanted one like that? Okay, there you go. There it is. Now, when somebody sends me something like this, you know, a knife made from somebody else, I can't make it identical. I have to put my touch to it, because I don't want to be accused of copying somebody's work. But that is the same style. Now this is 1095 high carbon steel also. It's pretty close. A little bit bigger. I have a little bit more of a belly, but I think that's I think that's pretty close. That'll do you a good job for a long time. That's coming out to you, and I'm going to send this one back to with you as well. Let's see, Anthony. There's your fillet knife. There you go. That will fillet anything you come across. Look, I lost my homemade Band-Aid there. Cut my thumb a while ago. Just a little bit. It happens. Now, these next three, I'm going to call the Stedhomer Collection. My buddy Stedhomer up in Ohio sent me some patterns and some cherry wood back a long time ago. I'm way behind on getting these to you, but here's one for you. There you go. I think that's pretty close to the pattern you sent me. Now Stedhomer designed these himself, and I think they're pretty cool. They look almost like a fish, like a shark. It feels real good in the hand. You got a little bit of, got a little bit more grip. Use that gut hook, pull it down. So that'll be coming to you. He sent me three patterns. This one, this one, which is pretty close to that one, pretty close to the same thing. Yeah, felt nice. Well designed. Now this one here is a smaller one. Pardon me. The Master Sergeant was over the other day and he stitched this one for you. Put a running chain stitch. He likes that stitch a lot. this one is much smaller. How about that? What do you think about that? Alright, that will be on the way to you. Well, I'll have three of these here. And I appreciate those patterns. If y'all hadn't watched Stead Homer's channel, I'm going to put a link down in the box. Y'all go check him out over there. He's a very interesting guy. Has built a fine barn. Just absolutely beautiful barn. And he's closing in one side of it for Mrs. Stead Homer for her little shop. Pardon me. My wife actually sat down and watched some of it with me last night and the night before. And she said, I want a shop like that. I want a little room like that. So, thanks a lot, buddy. Now I got work to do. But anyway, y'all go check him out. Great guy. Very, very great guy. All right, upcoming projects. I think I might have showed these a long time back. This is something else I'm way behind on doing. I've got some restoration projects. Look at that thing. This is a kukri. I don't think you're going to be able to see it, but it's handmade in India. This came from India. From a friend of mine that is a friend of mine's father-in-law is a Vietnam vet. And he was all over the Middle East back in the day. And he brought this back with him. The handle's been broken. It was taped up. I got to untape it and see what all we got to do. On this one and the next two I'm going to show you, I'm going to do a different type of finish on the metal. And I'll show you that when I get to it. Pardon me. I think I showed you all these cleavers. These are Dexters. I still hadn't researched them a lot, but do the same thing, gonna refinish the steel. I'm gonna work on the handles. That one's about the size of the ones I normally make. And remember this beast here. Boy, I like this thing. Pardon me. But this is a family heirloom, so I tried talking out of it, but I can't, so that's fine. You can see the handle is split. Pretty sure I can fix that. Get some new rivets to put in there. Refinish the steel. Looks like somebody's taking a hammer to it. So I can clean that up, get that fixed up. And see, what else I got to show you? Oh, Master Sergeant was over. He brought me a gift that he found. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Remember the survival knife rebuild we did back last year? I'm going to turn the camera on and start coughing. He found one. This is an Air Force issue survival knife. This is what they issue to the pilots. This one's not, the one I had before was a little bit bigger than this, I think. But this one, he brought to me and made me a gift of it. Pretty cool. And it's all intact. It's not in bad shape at all. Now this is leather, stacked leather. All I'm going to do to it, I'm going to clean the leather up. And this is brass. I'm clean this up, polish it. The guard's a little loose. Oh, got it. A little bit loose, but I can fix that without having to take it apart. The blade's in very good shape. It's even sharp still. But I'm going to strip that down, re-blue it, get it all fixed up. I'm going to build a new sheath for it. This one, unlike the last one, has the metal guard on it all the way. It's all in one piece. It's all in good shape. little issue right there, but you can see that. But not a big deal. I can fix that. And when I get this one fixed, it is mine. Now I'm going to keep this one. Yeah, thank you, Master Sergeant, for that. Let's see what else we got coming up around here. Thank everybody for the comments on the smokehouse. Went to town yesterday morning. Me and Mama spent most of the morning in town paying bills and doing this and that and the other. And we went by the Walmart, so I got me some of that. So guess what color the smokehouse is going to be? My favorite color. Alright, I think that's everything I was going to show you. I'll take these inside. Make sure to let them sit for a couple hours. Make sure they're good and dry. They feel good and dry. But the humidity out here is just awful. And I know I fuss about the weather. I fuss when it gets hot. I fuss when it gets cold. But I'm getting older, so that's what I do. I fuss about stuff. So. And pardon me, my northern friends, if you've never spent a summer down south, in the deep south, I'm deeper south than deep south homestead. We're further south than they are. If you never spent a summer down here, you don't know what humidity is, and you don't know what heat is. So, don't give me no crap. You know who you are. But anyway, I think that's all for tonight. I think I'll close up and go inside and take me another nap. Get up in the morning and start again until the heat builds, and then I'll go inside and take another nap. So, anyway, I appreciate all my subscribers. Getting new subscribers all the time. Thank y'all for being here. Thank you for watching. And I thank y'all for your support. And I've got more knives to start this week, and I'll show you all those after, maybe after the weekend. I'll have some of those done. So once again, thanks for watching. Thank you for your support, and I will see you later.